Hi everyone, I am Cyanide Games, and this is the Dark Pictures Anthology, The Devil in Me. This is a game I've been waiting for a long time, came out last year, and I've been meaning to actually get back, start recording gaming videos. But this game in particular I wanted to play because this is actually based on the H.H. Holmes Murder Castle, which is an actual, who was an actual person. If you ever watched American Horror Story Hotel, that season's somewhat based around his actual hotel with rooms. It's very weird. Best just to look it up. But this game is based off of that. Wait, this actually has? The skills will be tested. Death is inevitable. We're going to put it challenging. These type of games. These are the people that made Man of Medan, The Quarry, and Until Dawn, and some other Dark Pictures Anthology games. These are the games that where choices matter. Every choice you make, we'll choose a different outcome. Yes, turn this. And I'm jumping right into it. Graphics don't look too bad. Every choice has a consequence. Right now, because I'm starting a new channel on right now. This might be on my new one, but I'm trying to think of a new name for it. Because I have a new setup, because I have a better setup, and this is so far going to be like a somewhat of a test video. Ooh, there.
The wheel is 264 feet, Jeff. Can you imagine it?
I'm attempting to.
I bet you can see for 100 miles at the top. We should make that.
Hold on. The murder hotel is
whatever pleases you the most.
Yeah,
the most.
You mean you are not weary of me after an entire day of marriage?
I will never be weary of you.
I shall hold you to that, my dear.
The hotel is actually in Chicago. It's been boarded up, though. I believe. I could be wrong.
I think we've arrived.
Isn't this grand?
As advertised. Very nice.
That does look very, very beautiful.
Let's check in.
I think this is the very first horror game I've seen actually
this morning to get to the fair.
As I was gonna say, the first horror game based off an actual true event, I do believe. I could be wrong. I'd say the first one based on a serial killer, I should say.
Well, this does not bode well for the level of service we're in store for.
I forgot to mute my TV. Choose.
Let's not wait till tomorrow.
Let's just be excited.
Let's sign in and go straight there.
We're not going anywhere if no one checks us in.
Slow service. That means they're making sure everything is perfect.
That's my Marie. Always finding that silver lining.
My sincere apologies. For both startling you and for making you wait.
And that is H.H. Holmes.
Needed elsewhere. I promise from here on out.
Okay. You have only made choices with your heart where possible. That's weird. I'm gonna quickly say though, with this gameplay, There's no going back. It's just going forward. So the choices I make, I'm not going to go back. I'm but not going to change it.
Welcome to the World's Fair Hotel. Please, sign in here. First time in Chicago. I'm going to hazard a guess and assume you're here to take in the exposition.
The fair, yes, but that's not all. Today is a very special day for us.
Oh, a honeymoon. How very, very lovely.
Perhaps my wife, Mrs. Whitman, would like to sign. Yes, today's the beginning of our honeymoon.
Congratulations. In that case, an upgrade is in order. A honeymoon suite it is.
Okay,
oh,
just...
well, are the rates that much higher?
I think nothing of it. The same rates as your regular room. The upgrade is on us. You're our first honeymooners.
How kind. Thank you, Mr.
Holmes. Henry Howard Holmes.
You have a lovely hotel, Mr. Holmes.
Well, thank you very much. I designed and built most of it myself.
You're an architect, then?
Architect, designer, builder, doctor, artist. I'm a man of many interests.
Impressive.
Please, have a look around. We have sundries and gifts at the pharmacy counter.
I don't like this
I'll
one bit.
Take your luggage up to your room and ensure that everything is in order. Just make a note if you decide to purchase anything, and we will add it to your bill.
I do know somewhat of the plot of this game, but
Thank
I don't
you,
know
Mr.
the
Holmes.
Full of it.
We appreciate it.
The pleasure is all mine.
So I do know the actual main plot is documentary is supposed to go into the H.H. Holmes Hotel and investigate something. I don't remember what, but then it turns into like a Saw-like type deal. Which I'm a big fan of the Saw movies. I'm gonna turn my mic down a little bit or just...
Now, what did I forget to bring?
Let's take a look at that. I'm just gonna turn it. Bring up the. Oh.
Oh. Pardon me, miss.
Careful, you. My husband gets awfully cross with men who act fresh.
He sounds like a ripe fellow. How's the marriage going?
Lovely. Thanks for asking.
Well, let's just head up. I'm sure the room is ready.
See anything good over there at the jewelry counter? Anything fancy?
Wouldn't you like to know?
See, I'm not liking this for just beginnings. For the simple fact is, I know what's happening. I already know some of what happened in that hotel just from watching documentaries. I
wonder what's in here.
I'm starting to think I've gone and married a thrill seeker. Ferris wheels, forbidden rooms. Are we looking for excitement?
Perhaps.
Nothing but an unfinished room. See what happens when you chase a thrill?
If this is you trying to get out of the Ferris wheel.
I know you won't be denied.
Wait, what's that?
No.
Don't move.
Press X time at the heartbeat. But mentions triangle key. Oh, it's one of these deals. Ooh. So I don't have this on hard. I just have this on pretty much normal difficulty. Here we go again. I'm just gonna look over here.
That was a thrill.
You won't think it's thrilling if we're sleeping on the street after getting kicked out of here. Let's go.
Welcome, newlyweds, to the honeymoon suite.
Thank you kindly, Mr. Holmes.
Do enjoy your stay. If you'll excuse me, I have work to return to.
Yeah.
I'm sure we'll see each other again soon.
Goodness, this place is fit for a king.
Or my queen.
Oh, you.
Oh, sorry about that.
Kiss this.
That is not very wifely of you.
Yeet.
Hey!
Ah, bullseye!
You asked for it.
Should I be frightened?
If you're smart.
I'm gonna yeet this so goddamn hard. I caught it, bitch.
Mercy, mercy. Okay, you win.
Anything broken?
Only my pride. How about a peace offering?
This feels like some sort of treacherous plot.
Not at all. I have a gift for you. Close your eyes and face the mirror.
Aren't you clever and romantic? If I get a pillow to the face, I will sock you right in the kisser. Is there a problem?
No.
So which one of those secrets?
Open your eyes.
Oh, Jeff, it's lovely. I love it.
Good. Victory is mine. I'll let you have that bath now.
That's either a button or a camera or a people.
Jammed shut.
Maybe if we put a little weight into it? Open sesame!
Thank you. Why don't you have a shave while I take a quick bath? Then we can reconvene.
I know that word. It's French for something illicit.
Shush. Shave.
I think I forgot to pack my razor and kit.
I'm sure the pharmacy downstairs has them.
Don't be too long in that bath.
Don't you worry.
Jeff the Roach. God, how weird the gameplay is, because it's like an actual movie. fucking... Well, fuck it.
Better not.
Better should. Get the fuck in there, bitch. Okay. See, I don't really like being in here, even though it's a game, because
I could have sworn this was the way we came up. What?
I knew something was gonna happen. If it's on two kicks, right. Rosewater? I probably picked. I didn't know. I knew something was gonna happen because the room, the hotel changed. Like, the way H.H. Holmes made it. Every room you enter is different. It changes somehow. And I... See, our main objective with this playthrough... With this playthrough is to get everyone... Try to get everyone to survive. And not die, hopefully. Okay.
Is that you, darling? Jeff? Oh, are we playing another game?
Let's just relax. I should have investigated the noise. Nope, I fucked up and I can't go back.
Back already? You know, this tub is awfully big. I think there might be room for another body. Oh. That's nice. Ow. You don't know your own strength. Easy, dear. Jeff, that hurts.
Hello, my dear.
Quiet now.
We don't want to disturb the other guests.
Let go of me! Let go of me!
I really thought you'd have a little more fight in you.
Good thing I picked out a rose bottle. Oh no, there was.
We are. Nice and quiet.
No.
What are you doing? If you've touched Maria,
you're a bit late with that sentiment, good sir. Is there a problem, sir?
Don't ask me fucking gas. Oh, that's not what it was, but it's gas.
Breathe!
No. I think there was no chance of those two even surviving. I probably could have made them survive longer, but... And that jewelry in there is not actually bought jewelry.
This.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Only the best for you, my dear.
Mother would simply die. It's so
I say,
opulent.
Good man, do you work here?
Hello. Welcome to the World's Fair Hotel.
Oh. Won't you spare me over till another year?
So this is only the second game I've played made by the Dark Pictures and made part of the Dark Pictures anthology. Because the next one I'm going to play are Little Hope and the House of Ash. And I really like how you... I really like how the game has that intro sequence, then it goes into this, like an actual movie or TV show. By Supermassive Games people that made the Quarry. The first game I played by them was Until Dawn, and that game pretty much it was phenomenal when it first came out. Because it was games like that, Heavy Rain, Beyond Two Souls, kind of set up these type of games. Yeah, I'm gonna turn the mic. Mic's getting red. Okay, that's probably better. Try that up there.
Oh, you're here. Have you been waiting long? Welcome back. I do enjoy seeing a familiar face. Last time, no one survived. I wonder if you were even trying. It's so good to have company. For a long time, I was on my own. I can barely recall a time when I wasn't here. Watching over these tales. And what good are stories without somebody to experience them? This is a story about those who create and the lengths they might go to for their art to be made pure. Art can elicit all sorts of reactions. Delight, inspiration, desire, yes, but also doubt, fear, dread. The way you react, the decisions you make, will affect this story. Hidden in the world, you'll find dark pictures. They give glimpses of the possible consequences of your choices. And sometimes, it's the smallest choices that can have the biggest repercussions. You're responsible for what happens. You're culpable. I can't interfere. That's very much against the rules. I can only observe what happens and record any significant events. Oh. Ever seen one of these? They're very old. People used to call them obols. They'd put them in the mouth of the recently deceased to pay the ferryman. Look out for them. You'll find them in the strangest places. I'll be happy to exchange any that you find, and I'll certainly make it worth your while. Well, shall we start? Game is afoot. I will be watching.
My name is Kate Wilder. I've got a master's in criminal psychology. I'm an investigative journalist and hope to make a difference. You may have recently seen my interview on Chicago AM on ticket accounts. And yeah, it's really tough when just being honest means everyone thinks you're a bitch. I'm not. Sure, I've got issues to deal with, same as everyone. I'm working on it.
Hey, I'm Mark. I study photography at UCLA. Had a great time. Really want to get back into some serious photography. But yeah, it's a job.
I've been a key grip in lighting tech for years. See a problem, light it. You don't often meet someone like that. Man, how do you even start?
And my favorite thing about these type of games, these and the ones that have Heavy Rain Beyond Two Souls developers did. They used actual actors' likings for their characters. Like when you play The Quarry, one of the characters in The Quarry is actually... one of the voice actors is David Arquette from the Scream movies. They used... They modeled the actors. It's the best way to explain it.
It's a fucking mess, to be honest with you.
And I'm terrible at explaining things.
We've heard quite enough.
Enough? Oh, I've barely begun, Your Honor. You don't seem to understand. I was born with the devil in me. I could not help the fact that I was a murderer any more than a poet can help the inspiration to sing.
Wait, why does this face look different?
Bury me deep, Your Honor. Make sure they fill my pine box with cement. Put me deeper than anyone else. And cover the ground with more cement. Cause trust me. Just being dead ain't enough to stop me from killing again.
On May 7th, 1896, Herman Mudgett, a.k.a. Henry H. Holmes, was sent to the gallows. His neck did not snap from the force of hanging. Records indicate he hung, slowly suffocating for over 15 minutes, until finally the monster was dead. America's first serial killer confessed to 27 murders. But his investigators sifted through the traces he left behind, following his path from city to city. The number grew significantly. Nearly 200 lives. America's first serial killer, and possibly the worst.
That was a reenactment they were doing.
He was buried as requested, under concrete. Was he hoping to hide from God's judgment? Or did he truly want to keep the devil from climbing out and killing again?
I'm gonna like this one so far. I wasn't a big...
What do you think?
To be honest, Charlie, this is a pilot.
I wasn't a big fan of the ending of Man of Medan because I called it from the very beginning of that one.
Charles Lonnet, please.
Speaking. Charlie is fine.
My name is Grantham Dumet.
What can I do for you, Mr. Dumet?
Actually, it's what I can do for you. Hear me out.
I'm certainly grateful to you, Mr. Dumet. This all sounds amazing, but I'm waiting to hear what the catch is. No offense.
None taken. I'm in a privileged position. I don't need for much. But my time is at a premium. We need to do this today. I'll send a car for you this afternoon. 4 p.m. Be ready.
This afternoon? We're talking a couple of days shoot. I've told my team they're free this weekend, and frankly, they're a temperamental bunch. Without them, this conversation is dead in the water.
I've told you what I have. Please don't waste my time. Am I sending the car or not?
Yes, of course. We're in. I'll get them there. I promise. Let's do it.
They're going to the E.G. Thomas Hotel.
Mr. Dumet, send you. We... Right. Let's load up, guys.
All right, got it.
Sorry for talking over the game.
Sorry.
But I could be wrong. That voice over the phone sounded like H.H. Holmes.
You're right.
This is going to be grand.
It sounded a lot like H.H. Holmes from the beginning of the game.
Excitement.
Again, I could be wrong.
Anyone?
Road trip.
Huzzah.
Woohoo.
Hooray.
This is going
to
be great.
Like I said, we're going to give this video. This is supposed to be a Saw-like game, so... It's literally, they go into the H.H. Holmes Hotel and it turns into Saw.
Do we know where we're going exactly?
I think that's how they came.
You know what this reminds me of?
Don't say.
Topeka? Exactly. Me, no money in my pocket, a dead phone, and lost in the middle of goddamn Topeka.
That wasn't my fault.
It was 100% your fault. Because you fly by the seat of your ass. So, come on, Charlie. What do we know about this guy?
He's rich, he's a recluse, he's obsessed with H.H. Holmes. Totally sane, I'm sure.
We're going to a property he inherited from a relative. That's who had the obsession with Holmes. Some of the rooms are full recreations from the murder castle. Dumet has blueprints, documents, artifacts. When I said this would save the show, I was not exaggerating.
And you substantiated all of this?
Just trust me.
Sorry for all the mystery. Before we go any further, I have to ask that we lock up your phones for safekeeping. While this may sound strange that I invite you to film the collection inside my home, I cannot allow any personal devices that may share information that could affect my business or lifestyle. There are rules. All footage you wish to use must be authorized by me first. I require privacy and discretion. I must insist.
His place, his rules. Look, what he's offering us is worth it. Could be making us pay, but he isn't. If this is all he asks, then we do.
Fine.
So this
for the show
sounds a lot. And
I'm telling you, this is going to be great.
You said that in Topeka.
I think with the H.H. Holmes castle, I think that's how they came up with the idea for Saw 2 a little, but in like other movies based on, like that, like the house with the traps. So I'm curious on what the actual thing is with this one. If
this dude is so rich, shouldn't he have service or something?
If the spirit of H.H. Holmes came out.
I got it. Thanks, bro. Don't sweat it, jackass.
Okay. So now what?
I'd love to get some footage of the lake and the scope of this.
Not with all the mist and fog.
There. From on high, we'll get a better look.
That's... certainly, up there. The visuals will be great. We can frame up over the mist.
Charlie, you'll hack up a lung before you're halfway up there.
I'm fit as a butcher's dog.
Mark, this is crazy.
We'll be fine. Let's go, Charlie.
Be careful, guys.
Nice knowing you.
Come on.
Hold on, I'm gonna pause this real quick. I'll be right back. Yeah, I'm back, so I love that. God damn it. shoot some footage from top of the lighthouse. Yeah, let's look. Oh, I forgot you can't sprint. Can we talk to any of these? Collections and characters. So we have Charlie, Aaron, Jamie, Kate, Mark.
This is taking too.
So.
Hey, guys, hurry up!
We're on it.
So I don't know if the game actually takes place in the actual castle, or in a recreation of it.
Jesus, that is loud.
It's meant to be heard from miles away.
Well, yeah, I know that in theory, but...
Oh, so much for plan A.
We must be able to work our way around. Come on.
Anything for the shot, right?
I'm gonna try and look around.
We're warning about everything falling into the ocean. I'm gonna say we trust it and not die.
Nah, this sign is something the lawyers made them put up. I'm sure it's fine.
Hard disagree.
Listen, Mark, I just wanted to say, thanks for backing me up, man.
What? About getting this footage?
No, for the whole trip. You know some of the crew can be challenging to work with. Jamie and Kate would never have agreed to come if you hadn't been on board.
I figured that the episode was such a mess. We needed all the help we could get.
Right. Yeah. I guess we do.
This is dark over there. So let's...
Okay, I won't lie. I was hoping being here all remote and away from the world that maybe I'd have some downtime, some space to decompress.
Downtime? Why would you want to do that?
You know, relax a bit.
I've never seen the attraction. Must have been quite a storm.
But I am going to try and look around the best I can.
Hey, when we wrap, I'd like to take a couple weeks off. Go see my family.
I need you in post. I really appreciate that discerning eye of yours, you know.
I got a lot going on at the moment, Charlie.
Oh, right, yeah, of course, sure. Take a couple of weeks. Get your head together.
I appreciate it.
I'll be fine in post on that.
Okay, so the game obviously is cool. But I'm gonna end off this episode off here. I'm not gonna make them an hour long. I'm going to try to make them, every game I play, I'm going to make parts short and not long for right now. So far, I like where this game is going so far. To the beginning, I did not like, for the simple fact is, I knew what was going to happen because H.H. Holmes is one of those things that in that hotel, it's like, you read what happened, you watch shows about it. It's not good. It's not a good thing. But I think, again, this is the first game based off a serial killer. But like I said, I'm going to end off this episode off here. If you like what you see, hit like, hit subscribe. I'll see you all in the next episode.